So for better understanding of this Ohm's law, just I'm taking the water and a pipe analogy. So let us see. So now we are taking three parameters in that water and pipe analogy. That is, the water is filled in the tank and that is transferred to the container through this pipe. So I'm taking the parameter of height difference between the top of the pipe and top of the tank and the pipe, and diameter of the pipe, and what is the force of water flowing through the pipe. These are all the three parameters, and these parameters are related to the parameters used in the Ohm's law. So let us consider the first diagram. Here the height difference between the top of the tank and the pipe is 10 feet. So if I am going to decrease the height difference, means what will happen? So the 10 feet height difference is reduced as 5 feet in the second diagram. So what will happen? The force of water flowing through the pipe is also decreased, right? So if I am increasing the height, the force of water flowing through the pipe is increased. Suppose I am decreasing the height difference, means what will happen? Automatically the force of water flowing through the pipe is decreased. Okay, so the force of the water flow is directly related with the height difference, right? So here consider the force of water flow in that particular pipe is directly proportional to height difference between the top of the tank and the pipe, right? So next consider, so consider this pipe. So consider diameter of this pipe and this pipe. So the diameter of this pipe is somewhat less than the pipe used in the case 1. Okay, suppose the diameter is very high, the force of water flowing through the pipe is also decreased. Suppose the thickness or diameter of the pipe is decreased, what will happen? The force of the water flowing through the pipe is increased. So if you are increasing the diameter, the force of the water flowing through the pipe is decreased. The diameter is decreased means the force of water flowing through the pipe is increased. So the force of water flow is inversely proportional to the diameter of the pipe, right? So this is the equation. The force F is directly proportional to height difference and the diameter. So if I am increasing the height difference, the force is increased. So the force is directly proportional to the height difference. Suppose the diameter is increased, what will happen? The force of water flow is decreased, and vice versa. So the force is direct inversely proportional to diameter of the pipe. So this equation is used for the better understanding of Ohm's law, right? So consider, this is the electrical circuit. So in this electrical circuit, voltage is applied to this circuit so that the current flowing through the circuit is I. So R is the resistance of the circuit. So now the current flowing through the circuit is analogous to the force of water flow, that is F, and the voltage between the resistance is analogous to height difference between the top of the tank and the pipe, and the resistance used in the circuit, the value of resistance used in the circuit is related with the diameter of the pipe, right? So we know the formula. F is directly proportional to height difference divided by diameter. So the force, right, the current is analogous to force of water flow, and the voltage is analogous to height difference between the top of the tank and the pipe, and the R is analogous to the diameter of the pipe. So instead of force F, we are going to use I, and the height difference is replaced by V and diameter is replaced by R, right? So here, according to Ohm's law, the current is directly proportional to V by R, right? So the force is replaced by current, and the height difference is replaced by voltage across the resistance, and the diameter of the pipe is replaced by R. So the current is directly proportional to voltage, that is called Ohm's law, and the proportionality constant is 1 by R, right? So the Ohm's law states that the electric current is proportional to voltage and inversely proportional to the resistance R. The electric current flowing through a fixed linear resistor is directly proportional to the voltage applied across it and inversely proportional to the resistance, right? Okay, so the Ohm's law states that the current flowing through the circuit is directly proportional to voltage across the particular resistance, and inversely proportional to resistance of the particular resistor. So this Ohm's law is only applicable at constant temperature. This is very, very important condition. So Ohm's law is only applied for the circuit is operating under constant temperature. Suppose the temperature is variable, at that time the resistance also varied, because the resistance is temperature dependent, so that the Ohm's law is not applicable. So Ohm's law state that the current I is directly proportional to voltage, and the current I is inversely proportional to the resistance. So that just compare the electrical circuit with the water pipe. If you are increasing the voltage of the circuit, the current flowing through the circuit is also increased. At that time, the resistance R will be maintained as constant. So if you are increasing the resistance, that will reduces the current flow, that is restrict the current flow in this particular circuit. Just we are maintaining the voltage as the constant. So here, so in the electrical circuit, if you are increasing the voltage, the current is also increased. So like the high difference increases in high difference increases the force of water flow in the water pipe. And if we are increasing the resistance of the electrical circuit, that will reduces the current flow. Like increased diameter reduces the force of water flow in the particular water and pipe. So this is the comparison. So with the help of this concept, we can easily understood the relationship between voltage, current and the resistance in the particular electrical circuit. So the Ohm's law finally states that at constant temperature, the current flowing through the circuit is directly proportional to the voltage across it. So the proportionality constant is nothing but R, that is the resistance in the particular circuit. So we can write that equation also, I is equal to V by R. So bring that R from right side of the equation to the left side, we can write it as IR is equal to V. So we can also write the equation as V is equal to IR. So this is the Ohm's law equation. So according to that Ohm's law statement, it's nothing but at constant temperature, the current is directly proportional to voltage. This is the correct statement, not voltage is proportional to current. So the Ohm's law correct statement is at constant temperature, current is proportional to the voltage. That is, the current flowing through the circuit is proportional to the voltage across the circuit. Okay, thank you. So if you are liking this video, kindly like, share and subscribe my channel Triple E Encyclopedia. Thank you.